Welcome, Aquarius. My name is Rena Wells, and I'm here to do your June predictions. This is for Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, and North Node. Whatever you are pulled on my channel, even if it's not your sign, guys, go take a look. Follow your intuition. There's always something here for you. If you are new, welcome. Don't forget to like and subscribe and comment. It really helps my channel grow. And if you want to work with me, I am doing readings in June. So take a look down below. If you send me an email if you would like a reading. It's not usually open to the public, but I do them in spurts. So if you are called, all that info is down below. Let's take a look, Aquarius. This is Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, and North Node. Let's take a look. So what is going on for Aquarius? We're looking at foundation, and then we'll look at love and everything else. But this is everything but love at this point. Spirit is really showing here, Aquarius, that you are looking for a better stability. If you notice, this feminine energy is holding this stick, and it is on a tree, okay? But this tree stump is not very sturdy. It's not dependable. You don't know when that's going to break. So I'm looking at June for you, Aquarius. You're looking for something that's actually grounded. Something where you can see tangible results, and this is in money and finances, relationships. You're really looking at, you know, how can I become more stable, less dependent on the system, more dependent on myself. I'm seeing a lot of sustainability as well. And this is, and I'm seeing sustainability because this tree is like, it's growing, but if it gets any bigger, you know, you have a lot of big dreams, Spirit is saying. It's not going to be able to be grounded on this thin limb here. You need a strong tree trunk, you know, to be able to hold this. And if you're a divine feminine, you're coming into this knowing that you are seeking this type of stability in your life, and this is your goal in June. I'm seeing that you are walking away from things that no longer serve you, and you're coming into a place of transformation. So you've come into a place of enlightenment coming in June, because look at this, as the birds talk. Beautiful awakening here. Beautiful coming into your Spirit is saying Empress power, Emperor power, God, Goddess, and it's really looking at what can you actually bring to the table in regards to new contracts, new work endeavors. I'm seeing that you are really starting to want to learn how to work for yourself. You don't want to be dependent on government or a regular systematic job. And that's where I'm seeing the stability that's coming out. You're like, no, I really want something that is grounded in spirit and something that's going to birth a lot more results. So you're going through a massive transformation, and I see you being very successful with this. You've already been going through the transformation here, Aquarius. Spirit is saying that this is just a confirmation. These two cards here are just a confirmation of the work that you have already been doing. And so June, you're definitely going to start seeing a new vibration come in for you. I feel like I need to get some more. What else for Aquarius? I feel like there's another card that wants to come out. What else for Aquarius for finances and stability in the earth plane, Spirit? What other messages do you have here for Aquarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus for June? I feel like another card wanted to come out. There's two that wanted to come out. So, yeah, you're really seeing where in the past here, you've been running through massive cycles, right? And see how there's like an egg kind of in the middle here? And this has been karmic cycles over and over and over again. But, you know, they're saying that this is like the oyster in the middle of, you know, its shell, that the sand has to, you know, kind of move in this direction to irritate it to get this beautiful pearl, this egg, this new birth. So you're ready to birth into a new cycle. The June is going to bring a lot new vibrations. You're currently in this in-between stage right now in May, but come by the end of June, you're definitely going to be birthing a new vibration. You're going to be seeing tangible results. I see you're going to be, yeah, Spirit is saying you're going to meet new people. There's tangible results with those dreams, these high level of dreams and what you've been thinking about here, right? These, it's getting top heavy. So you're about to really start grounding it. You're going to be getting the roots into the earth. to really start grounding this. What else do you have for Aquarius, please, Spirit? What else for Aquarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus, and North Node? Make sure you look at your North Node, guys. It is the direction that you're moving towards in your soul calling. It really defines a lot about your mission work. So for instance, mine is Libra. So mine is all about relationships and balance, karmic balance. I've had a huge amount of karmic cycles to heal in this life, let me tell you. So yeah, take a look at that. The South Node is what you're moving away from. Let's take a look. What is going on for Aquarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus in regards to stability and finances in June, please, Spirit? Okay, we have exchanging gifts and building blocks. Exactly what I was saying. So you're going to be meeting new people, new tribe members, new people are going to be coming in that are going to bring the resources that you've been looking for. You have gifts that you know that you can give to partners, soul tribe family, friends, family, lovers, whatever this is. It's about new connections to build something brand new, to build that foundation, to get those roots in. And Spirit is saying that, you know that you've had gifts that you can give to other people, and you know that they have gifts that they can give to you. So it's going to be a nice equal exchange here for you, Aquarius. What else for Aquarius in regards to money? It's going to be balanced in your money. You've been having problems right now. It's definitely going to change. It's a change in the wind right now as I'm saying that. So even in regards to finances, things are definitely going to be on the up and up coming in June. If you've had an idea, Aquarius, Spirit is saying write it down. They're telling me that you're getting these ideas. They're showing me like you're doing something else like housework or something like that, and you get an idea and you're like, ooh, that's a good idea, but you don't stop to write it down, and then you think about it later and you're like, what was that? And they're saying it's fleeting moments like that, that you're getting a lot of downloads. This is also why I'm saying it's top heavy. It's not grounded. You need to actually write down those ideas right now and start implementing them, because you're getting these messages for a reason. And it's definitely to help with this change in the wind. Okay, so there's a brand new direction that is coming for you. What else for Aquarius? I feel there's another one that wants to come out. Yeah, I was feeling this too, this time to go into something else, because there's community. It's exactly a validation what I'm saying. Time to leave that old vibration, that cyclic energy here, and leaving community, an old community, and moving into a brand new community. That's that cycle that you're going round and round about, but that's like you ready to birth this new egg here. Okay, let's pull some tarot and see what else is going on for Aquarius. Yeah, so it's gonna happen very quickly, Aquarius. So I want you to come back and tell me how it goes, because I really feel that, you know, come by mid-June, they're telling me, to the end of June, you're definitely going to see this new unfolding. So you're really ready to step into this higher calling. Okay, what else for Aquarius here, Spirit? What else for Aquarius? The Sorceress came out, which is the High Priestess. You're using your intuition on this. It's been guiding you. So Spirit wants you to know that you are getting those downloads, those ideas that were coming through. You need to really start writing them down, Aquarius, even if they seem like you're thinking, oh, I'll remember it. Spirit's like, no, you're getting ideas. The veil is lifting. The curtain is lifting. You're getting into the higher realm. So a lot of new innovative ideas are going to be coming through. Spirit really wants you to pay attention to it, because you're ending toxic cycles. Karma. Ending old relationships, things that were addictions, things that, you know, not good for you. And Spirit is recognizing that, you're getting on a brand new spiritual path, the Page of Wands. Okay, so something new is definitely developing here for you, Aquarius. Yeah, a new path in love in relationships, love in friendships, love in entrepreneurship. If you've been getting pulled to blogging and starting a platform, I would definitely start. Spirit is saying you may not be ready to like be out there in the world yet, but if you are, definitely go and do that, because that's for some of you. And for others, it's really about writing all of these things down and putting like a business case, a business plan in order. You're going to start seeing that God is like really bringing in this cup of love to start grounding this in your spiritual path. This is about mission work, Aquarius. Okay, this is a lot of abundance here, right? That you're being offered something. They want you to start seeing the light that's starting to come into your life, and to take those opportunities. Might seem a little bit different than what you thought, but it's going to start moving very quickly. Knight of Swords. And I say that it's going to start moving very quickly for you. So start paying attention. Four of Cups, of the new offers that start to come in, could be from a Queen of Cups, a water sign. Okay, but it's definitely using your intuition and following that heart to pull you into that new vibration. vibration, okay? So there's definitely new things that are coming for you. Let's see, what else is coming for Aquarius? Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus, please. What is coming for Aquarius in regards to foundation, money, business, relationships? We'll do relationships and love in a minute, in a bit, but this is generic in regards to how you're relating to things. What is going on for Aquarius? What are new doors opening for Aquarius? Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, and North Node, please, for June, please. What are the new doors that are opening for Aquarius? Ooh, my hand is stuck because it's so damn stinking hot here in South America. All right. Yeah, see, you're taking action. You are being called to mend bridges. This may be something with a twin flame or a soulmate connection. This is my twin flame card in this deck about mending bridges, about coming into a union, two of the same. So if you've been called to merge and heal something with somebody significant, it's time to take action on that, Aquarius. Now, if you know that it's them taking, that it's them that need to take action, and you have that intuitive knowing, then somebody is going to be taking action on that. Let's get another card on that. Can you please clarify that, please, Spirit, with mending bridges for Aquarius? Yeah, it's a by the book, step by step process. So Spirit is saying that you have been going through your spiritual healing, your path. This is why you're ready to birth this new beginning. And it's really, it's going to happen fast. I mean, I keep getting this feeling of this quick action. So if you haven't been seeing action, Spirit is saying it's because you've been going like one step at a time. But once you finish that one step at a time, they're saying it's going to happen very, very swiftly. I'm seeing the Eight of Wands in my mind. It's a very blessed path that you're moving on. And see how she's like kind of sitting and floating and just being at peace and moving along. It's because it's a blessed path by Spirit. Somebody's going to take action towards you. You're going to be taking action. We have you're ending separation. Okay. So for some, it's a significant relationship, twin flame connection, but you're done your healing. Okay. That's also another thing. You're done your healing completely. And, where things haven't been given to you, that's an ending of that cycle. You're ending your healing where things haven't been given to you. You may have felt that, oh my God, I'm doing all this work. Where is it? I almost feel like Aquarius, you've been like, where is it? Why is this taking forever? And Spirit is like, it's on its way now. It has to do with your soul tribe family. You may have felt that you've missed opportunities, Aquarius, but you haven't, okay? Things are now about to be revealed to you. We have the Moon here in reverse. So you're done. You've done your shadow work. It's exactly what I was seeing. So, you know, all of this narcissistic energy, all of things that were blocked, things not happening for you. You're communicating, feeling like you're not being heard by the universe is what I'm feeling. It's almost like you're feeling God's not hearing me. Like, I'm communicating clearly. I'm doing all of these things, but it's like a narcissist. I'm dealing with some narcissistic people in my life, or I'm dealing with people that are blocked in my life, or something is not happening. Things were happening in the ethers, Aquarius. Anything that you have missed that is meant for you by your birthright is coming back for you. And that could be this twin flame connection. Let's take a look at love. Actually, Spirit is pulling me to just give you one more card from this journey's deck, soul's journey. Because you're really, it's going to happen fast. Be ready, Aquarius, okay? I keep seeing the Eight of Wands. It's going to happen fast. I'm surprised it didn't come out, but it's definitely going to be happening quickly. What else for Aquarius, please? For Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus, okay? So there may have been some worry here. Don't worry. It's coming. Your worry and your doubts, Aquarius, okay? It's because you were growing and balancing here. Don't be envious of what's happening here. We have a lot of worry and doubt here, okay? That's just the ego mind, because you haven't been seeing changes. Spirit knows you have been doing the work. You have walked away from things, but it takes time to integrate. Spirit is saying with this community card, you know, you have to wait sometimes on other people in your tribe to be ready as well. It's all in divine timing to put all those different pieces together. So it's definitely happening in growth and balance. Okay. So this is a beautiful place that you're coming into, and okay, it's showing you where your self-esteem in that waiting period of your manifestation is, where you're envious, right? Sometimes we look to other people and be like, well, they got it, and why is this not happening for me? But that's also looking outside of yourself, and everything that God wants you to do is from the inside, and it's helping you with your self-esteem. It's helping you gain confidence in your intuition, in your path, in your connection to Spirit, and how you are moving along in your mission. So that's really beautiful. Let's take a look at love. What is going on for love? What is going on with this mending the bridge for Aquarians? Sun, moon, rising, Venus, please, and North Node coming in June for Aquarians. What is happening in love spirit? What is happening? Ugh, you're burnt out with this twin flame. You're burnt out. Okay. Spirit's giving me it. Tell me to keep going. There's a few here. Okay. You're really burnt out. You may need time to rest, but things are going to, I think there's no rest for the weary is what I'm hearing. You may feel I'm not ready, or you may feel that they're not ready to give, what they have to offer, but Spirit is saying it's going to happen fast. Just give me a second. You're burnt out. This is all new for me. I'm overwhelmed. Two souls in one body, okay? So you both could be feeling this in this twin flame connection, soulmate, high-level soulmate, but there's a lot of burning out. There's going to have to be a rest, but Spirit is saying there's no rest for the weary, and they want me to pull one more because... Do you want me to take that? No, they don't want me to take that. Go. No rest for the weary because there's abundance here. So it's an action to this abundance. I'm getting pulled to do this Kipper deck for you guys. So they're saying there's no rest for the weary because you're going to feel burnt out, okay? Because things are going to happen very fast. You've been on a long journey here, Aquarius, okay? It feels a little tiring. You're hanging in there. You're pushing forward. You're not seeing your manifestation. Keep going. Things always seem worse right before things manifest. So you're going to feel burnt out. You may feel like that in June, but it's going to happen like boom, very quickly. You're feeling, I don't know if my twin, this is, both of you know, this is two souls in one body. I don't know how you feel about me. I don't know if this is a no. All of that uncertainty is going to happen very quickly because the journey is starting now, okay? So, Spirit, what do you have messages for June in regards to love, in regards to this burnt out feeling? What is this in regards to this burnt out feeling? Could be your twin, the main male that's feeling this, okay? Because of the waiting aspect, is like feeling burnt out. The Spirit is saying that it's going to move very quickly. Can you validate that moving quickly, Spirit? Yeah, because the decision's been made. Once that decision has been made, it's going to move very quickly. Okay, like working in the patterns over and over and over again, the cycle over and over. That's the burnt out feeling, okay? Spirit is saying there's something in court, something is going to resolve. A karmic justice is going to happen very quickly, and boom, love is right after that, okay? Let's clarify that with some tarot. Somebody is definitely returning here, but it's almost like you're both being stretched to your limits here, and then boom, it happens. Almost like when you first met and there was an activation. It's going to happen very quickly. It's going to take off very fast. Anything else for this connection, please, and love for Aquarians. Wow. Any other? Can you clarify here? We have the King of Cups in reverse and the Empress. Yeah, feeling that's the Divine Masculine right there. Feeling like he's been blocked, overwhelmed with the emotions. And that could be that burnt out feeling. But what is going to happen in June, Spirit? Oops, I dropped a card here. What is going to happen in June here, Spirit, with the Masculine energy? Yeah, see, Ten of Wands in reverse. He's clearing up all of those. He's finally clearing up. The Ten of Wands is closing off so that he can give to the situation Six of Pentacles. So something is going to happen very quickly, okay, that he's having an internal change, an internal tower moment in regards to divine feminine energy. He has been afraid of this in the past, but that's changing now because he wants to win this, okay? So something is going to happen very quickly in regards to love. Wow. What other messages do we have here in regards to love for Aquarians? Sun, moon, rising, Venus. What is going on for Aquarius, please? What other messages do you have here, Spirit? Yeah, okay. They want me to do in regards to love. They want me to just pull one more in regards to love with this deck, and then we're going to get some other final messages. So sorry, they switched up on there with me. What is going on, wellness island time? Because we're doing island time. They tell me to take it, so look at this. In love, this is what's happening in June. Someone who has the key to your heart and a lot of passion, it's going to take off. Do you hear that bird? They're talking. There's one bird over here talking to the other one. There's going to be some communication. Listen. Yes. And there's a response. I don't know if you heard that. I hope you heard that. But there are a lot of passion. Someone who holds the key to your heart is definitely coming forward, okay? And it's going to happen fast. There's communication coming in. I like you. Romance is blooming, okay? So there's definitely something happening here. All right, Aquarians, those are the final messages for you. I can't even. There's two birds sitting right here in front of me. They tend to come when I start doing readings, you guys. It's quite hilarious how nature responds to the energy. What is going on for Aquarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, and Libra? Some final messages here. Healing messages for Aquarians, please, for June in regards to their predictions of love and everything else, please, Spirit. You're coming into Priestess energy. Look at this. Priestess. How are you being called to step up and lead? Some really high energies coming forward here, you guys. Stepping into your more divine feminine energy. Accessing those gifts. Believing. Trusting. Allowing it to flow. Allowing it to come through. I know it's hard. I know it's been tiresome, but it's going to take off in June. You're coming to the end of this really long cycle. I think for some of you, years. They want me to take this one too. That came off. The top there. It's been years, okay? You have to share your voice. That's the calling. That's the mission. Everything that I was saying in that about starting something, those ideas, the platform, everything else, it's coming. Your ideas are going to be happening here. Look at this. Don't dim yourself to fit in. You are different. You are unique, and those gifts are ready to come out. Aquarius, how are you dimming your light in order to fit in? That's it. No more doing that. And Spirit is saying, Sisterhood of the Rose, beauty, devotion, Priestess, mystic teacher, you got this twice. You are here to lead, Aquarius. You have amazing gifts. It's time for you not to fit in, to be that unique voice and to help lead. You're here to trailblaze. You're here to, you know, merge this twin flame journey is what I'm seeing for some of you. I'm seeing that this love, this mending bridges, the building blocks, all of that, you're ending a cycle. It's going to happen fast for you in June, and I'm super excited for you. Don't forget to like and comment and subscribe if you want a reading. If this resonated for you guys, check out down below. Send me an email. We can definitely do a reading and get detailed. I get actual detailed information just by a first name, and we can definitely do that. And if you like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe, and we'll see you soon. So much love, Aquarians. Bye.